like to have Barry, so if you could do concerts with him again.
Does that count patches on like Barry in somebody's head? I think that when you're doing this job, the last thing you want is any kind of enemy if possible. So, I mean, I would love for absolutely every hatchet possible to be buried. That would be lovely. I'd like, especially for things to go back the way they were maybe 2 years ago, that would be great. I mean, I don't really particularly want to name names specifically, but...
Oh, wait, hold on. Can I bring something up?
Are you about to bury a hatchet with TV?
No, I just want to point out, 2 years ago we were playing Terraria, so... because it could relieve stress with me, baby.
I hated every minute of it.
I don't believe it. I will never believe that. I will never believe that.
I mean, yeah, pretty much any. I don't think you ever want to hate somebody for a long period of time. It's not healthy. I'd love for all of those to be buried, but a lot of that wasn't me in the first place, so it's really kind of up to them naming no names.
Hi guys, this is a question for all of you, I guess, but for Crendor and Dodger, would you ever consider breaking into the esports? So, what would they do?
I'm amazed at the competitive sport.
I honestly, like, to answer this in a not joking fashion, I wish so badly that I was good at any game. Like, if
that's
I was
the entire panel, which is that.
If I was, like, good enough at a game to actually participate in, like, if I was really, really good at TF2 and could participate in TFT tournaments, I think that would be so fun, because I love that game. When StarCraft was a lot bigger and I was watching way more StarCraft, I was like, God, I wish I was good at StarCraft. Just, you know, the games that I really enjoy watching, I always wish I was good at them. I love watching Street Fighter. I wish I was in Street Fighter. It would be really difficult to choose one. But I do think that the fighting game community is the most exciting, so I'd probably want to be part of that somehow.
I would want to be a competitive Blood Bowl 2 player.
The biggest Blood Bowl tournament ever was ours.
We did it!
Yeah, and I won it! Or I would just announce esports.
And how would you do that?
Oh, don't do this.
Well, I need a game first.
Okay.
Now we're going to Crendor down the field. Crendor, what is happening in Rocket League today?
It's getting pretty intense down here, Jesse. We got some crazy car action. The one car has smashed into the other car, has exploded, and the other car seems to be going down the street. Guys, he's got a goal!
That was the worst goal call.
He's got a goal!
No, I'm
the worst
people.
It was totally
wrong.
The other part of the question was...
Totalbiscuit. Would you ever consider expanding your esports empire into Heroes of the Storm? And in that case, would we see a battle of the Titans between you and Jesse?
Well, here's the thing, like, my team is South Korean, and this is American. So, I could kind of just do that anyway?
Nope. I welcome the chance.
But no, definitely not considered Heroes of the Storm. Absolutely not. I mean, that's what it is.
So is sticking around in StarCraft too long.
those suck.
So, a lot of people, there's always some moments in RPGs where there's one thing that occurs a lot of people dislike, especially favorite company or favorite brand like Mass Effect or Dark Knight. So, there's been one moment in any RPG that you think of that you wish you could rewrite because of how they changed the story and why they didn't. That's for any of you.
A moment in an RPG that we wish we could rewrite.
Yeah. I'm not sure an entire game counts.
That one needs.
It's all Jesse played.
The ending of Final Fantasy 12, I thought was pretty jank. Considering the rest of the game was like a cool kind of like pseudo Star Wars story, which I thought was. This is a very serious answer. I take this very seriously. I would rewrite that.
And then the end was just like sort of everything's fine. And I was like, no, that's not. But it really disappointed me, the ending of that game. I would completely rewrite like the last 2 hours of that game probably.
Also Xenogears. The second
I only get one.
Yes, the second disc.
Second disc is basically a book for like the first 3 hours. That's stupid. No, I got more.
There's of course a series on the Sega Saturn called Shining Force 3 that was in three parts. Problem is, they never officially translated or brought over parts 2 and 3, and they knew they weren't going to any kind of English language, so it's all in Japanese. So you have to, when you play the original, they rewrote parts of the ending where it kind of is, some awful thing has happened, and this Colossus has come and smashed up the city, and there's a coup going on, and everything's kind of crazy. Everything's fine, the end. it's pretty terrible, and it's a really bad ending to a very climactic kind of story and battle that was really leading up to somewhere. And Sega, in their many failures, never brought over parts 2 and 3. If I can add another one to that, Panzer Dragoon Saga, which also they lost the source code for because it's Sega, so we're never getting it again. There's no possibility of a remake because they lost the game. So,
oh my god, take this throwback. Yes.
What, Panzer Dragoon Saga?
No, I just lost the game.
Thank you.
stouts. It's been a lot of long lines, or very, very busy. So we are planning on doing that. Where that is, that's a great question.
Okay, Winlock.
So across the hall.
Across the hall.
Yeah, across the hall. So we'll be doing signing opposed probably for about 2 hours maximum, I think.
Now, I'm aware there are probably a few of you right now who are like, they're all going to be there. Why, that would be the best photo I could ever take. Please be considerate of those who have not had it. QCon me, and I will cry. So, it really just be considered for me, I think is what I'm saying. So, please let people who have just had nothing sign through. If you have something from, you know, a majority of us, just like chill. Hold back. Don't like jump in. And,
Jesse, I think it's your con, you need to give a closing speech.
Speech! 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 Speech!
You don't have to convince me to make me hear myself talk. I'll do it anyway. Thank you all so much for coming. This was incredible. I hope you had a wonderful weekend. I have heard from a bunch of you that this has been, I got a few birthdays, I had a wedding anniversary. Whoa. 1 year, this is the 1 year anniversary. What? Here's the best part. Yeah, here's the best part. She wanted to come here, which is, you've done very well, my friend. And to everyone else who didn't have a special reason to be here except for just hanging out with us, I'm honored and forever thankful that you would give this a chance and that we didn't end up giving you a pulpit. And I'm thankful to all of the helpers, and let's give them a round of applause. Hard time, but it's only because I wanted to be awesome, and hopefully it turned out that way. So. Yeah!